What it is, y'all, it is your old boy Pilk, and we're coming to 10, boss 1-10. We're gonna take this one on. If you guys haven't been following along, we've done all these other ones, basically just eviscerated these fights, and now we're gonna go into 1-10. You'll notice the team is very similar but also extremely different. Now, this is an aqua type, and you really need aqua killers. Unfortunately, there's only two aqua killers on the whole light team, and the only weakness is light. The only other aqua killers that I'm aware of, at least, are water types, and water types have a 40%, I guess, deficit, for lack of a better word. The foe you're going to fight is 40%, resilient against water types, so you really got to use a light type aqua killer to get the maximum amount of killing power out of this. And there's only two, and that is the Magic Lena, who I hope you really have, because I told you guys how good she was going to be when we got that event, and this old Chloe, which actually I think about from time to time, because she's got a really awesome skill for wargame, but nobody ever really uses her anymore, which is really unfortunate, because she's got a really interesting skill. Now, to be fair, she's not really going to be the end of the world for this. We're basically to be spamming Lena's SA, but Chloe's got a really cool skill that we're going to utilize to try to get a little bit more damage out. Now, what is the challenge here? Because it's a crazy looking team. Well, we have, and just because I never get to use these units, I even took the Isa's paid dress off so I could just watch this unit go to work. We are going to be using the April Fool's Eyes. These stats means she is going to squish very readily and very frequently. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to keep her basically alive. And she's not going to do anything. She's really going to hold no relevance to this team whatsoever. Everything else that we need done is going to be done by the rest of the team. But she's really just here more or less to be that kind of target for the foe that we have to help survive. And in this situation, and I'm going to be honest, this foe hits really, really, really hard. So this is actually going to be a bit of a challenge for me. I've got my healing's got to be on point. I got to kill him fast, quick, fast, and in a hurry. I really got to get in and out with this event. And this is to kind of show you, like, she's got the pretty much on the level of, like, almost, I wouldn't say a 3-star, but definitely a very low tier 4-star. So, and she's got no, she's got no hero ascension. I don't even think you can ascend her. I don't know. Can you? I don't think you can ascend the April. No, you can't. So she is going to be a very, very hard unit to keep alive. But if we can do this, you can keep your level 60 units alive. No questions asked. So let's go ahead and jump in here. See if we can make this happen. This is a bit of a sizable challenge. So keep your eyes on eyes. Boom. Okay. Now, like I said, we're going to come out of the gate with our usual buff debuff stack. Nothing unusual here. Goblin Slayer is going to have one purpose only. That's to drop physical resistance. Because while we do have a magic debuff, case in point, and a big light debuff, which is going to be actually Chloe's SA, we don't really have... I'm actually going to use her single target skill. I forgot she has these weird skills. So we're going to keep using her single target. I'm going to go into Yosuga. And the long and the short of it is, we're basically going to utilize Chloe's 50% light damage debuff with her SA, along with Lena, to really try to produce the kind of damage we're going to want to see out of this. Now, we got to pay close attention, because we will at some point lose our magic and strength buffs. So we've got to keep our eye on the icons. So notice I turned the icons on down here. And Eyes is here. Now I'm going to do Sheikah on this turn to try to get a little bit of extra damage out of everybody. He is debuffed 40%. But we need to make sure that that doesn't leave. We need to make sure that stays in play the entire match. So here we go. The goal is a double SA with Chloe and Lena. And then later on we're going to go ahead and do Lena's SA over and over and over again. Just because once we get Chloe's SA out, we're kind of done with that situation. We can buff her. We can actually go ahead and give her a buff. It won't hurt anything. We're definitely not going to be... we're not going to be setting any records with this Eyes. That's for certain. But like I said, you notice how much damage she took earlier. She is the challenge to keep alive. Now, the fun part is here, I have the sneaky suspicion that we actually might S-clear this, just because of how strong these other two units are. So, I'm hoping for something of that nature. But, yeah, we'll do that, that, there we go. I'm really hoping for a nice, clean S-clear, despite the deficit that's on the team. Because once again, I want to show you guys that you can go crazy with these teams. You don't necessarily, like, have to go full max limit break all the time. And I know I harp on this about a lot, but I know a lot of people don't have the max limit break units. And, you know, they're thirsty for teams that are going to be able to beat this. So, once again, you're not going to probably get a 9-turn finish like I'm kind of aiming for here. And I think it's well within the bounds of reality at this point. But you can get a good finish and you can get a lot of damage out if you really plan your teams out. Now, I really wish I had Lena at like +1/+2 to see what she does here. But actually, does she takes light resist down 50%. I forgot Lena did the same thing. What am I doing? All right. Well, basically, for the next 3 turns, we're just going to spam SA. So here we go. I could have had this out a little bit earlier, and that would have been a nice, clean finish. I forgot that Lena and Chloe had the same skill on their SA. I kind of honestly forgot Lena did that. All right. Boom. 2 million. And bear in mind, that's 2 million without the light debuff. Because remember, the light debuff takes basically goes into play after the attack. So turn 8, we're going to do another one. And then turn 9, we're going to go for the finish. Alright, so we're going to keep doing Yosuga. We're going to do Pico Hammer / Cheating Hands. And, once again, this SA. And, did we lose the magic buff? Nope, magic buff's still there. We're good to go. I wonder if we lost the magic buff, I believe, on the turn. Because you notice, yeah, no, strength buff's still there. I thought it removed the magic buff. Huh, weird. 2 mil, and then we got one more. Should be a really easy S clear here, like I said. And honestly, we would have probably done, maybe even gotten a 7-turn kill had I remembered that Lena does that debuff. On her SA. We could have done that SA turn 3 and just probably wrecked this in 6 or 7 turns. Probably closer to 7 turns. This team would be hard-pressed to do a 6 turn. Here we go! Boom. 2.1 mil. And he's dead. So, super easy. Now, once again, I want to preface that my Lena is max limit broken. Therefore, she is going to hit significantly harder than somebody's got them +2/+3. But at +2, you're probably still looking at a mil, maybe mil.25. So, it's very, very, very viable. As long as you have that Lena, she's going to be great. You want to maximize the weaknesses of your opponent. In other words, in this case, their weakness is light. And you want to maximize the amount of damage you're producing with a unit killer. In this case, aqua killers really are kind of the cream of the crop in this regard. So let's do this one more time and show you all the weaknesses before. Well, I mean, obviously there's a little bit of debuffing going on, but a physical unit is at a major disadvantage. So we really want to use light. This really is just made for Lena. This is 100% made for Lena. I'm going to be honest. Althea wouldn't be a bad unit here, but I'm going to be real. While Chloe is physical, she was helping out a lot, but to debuff this light even further would just be crazy. So if you've got Lena, 100% use Lena. I don't care if she's got no bonds in her whatsoever. She still is going to hit really, really, really hard. And as you saw with the eyes unit we were keeping track of, as long as you've got a good amount of healing and a good amount of defenses, you're going to be good to go. That's going to be the video, guys. Let me know what you guys thought in the comments section down below. Like, comment, share. I'm going to be back at you guys with more Danmachi here really soon.